Brave Rose Pierce from Hayling Island bid nearly £500 on a Wave 105 Cash for Kids charity auction for an aerobatic flight experience in a vintage Tiger Moth. The team from GoFly at Old Sarum Airport just outside Salisbury provide the plane and the expertise with pilot Mark, but Rose provides the bravery.
A little bit apprehensive, but yes, I'm really looking forward to this.
It's time to get strapped in and take to the skies in the 1930s vintage Tiger Moth.
So, one hand up on the bit there, okay, that's it. Hold on to that bit there, that's it, like that. Stand with your left leg in first, into there. Set yourself up, sit yourself down. Suck it, yeah, pull it out,
Are you ready, Rose?
I am indeed.
Okay. So, here we go. Full power. Race tail. As we go up, you'll start to see all of the fields of crop that are out at the moment, all the rape fields. Oh, you have to keep your microphone as close to your mouth as possible, Rose.
Yeah.
Here you go. I've got you now.
Okay.
It's gorgeous, isn't it? Okay, so follow me through on the controls. So put your right hand on the control stick in between your legs, and your left hand on the throttle, which is this thing here. Okay, so you won't have to move your left hand, and your feet go on the rudder pedals, which are these things here. Okay. Right, now, look out over the front of the aircraft. Can you see those cross wires? They are somewhere sort of near the horizon for you, aren't they? Right, okay. So what I'd like you to do, when I give you control, okay, what I'm going to do is ask you to do a certain number of things with the controls. Okay, so you have control.
Okay.
So you repeat back, I have control.
I have control.
Okay, now you're now flying the aircraft, and I'll just prove that by putting my hands up here and giving a tap on the shoulders.
Okay,
so you've got it. So if you wanted the nose to go down a bit, just a gentle pressure forward on the control column. You see, the nose moves forwards, downwards. Okay, so push that nose a little bit more.
Yeah.
Push it a bit more. Push it a bit more.
Oops.
And then you can see a bit more of the horizon. If you pull the control stick back a little bit,
yeah.
So pull it back a little bit, the nose comes up, doesn't it?
It does indeed.
And you can make the nose go where you want relative to the horizon just by pushing or pulling the control stick. Just a very gentle pressure movement. Now, if you move the stick to the left or the right, then the left wing will go down or the right wing will go down. So let's move the stick to the right then. So you move it to the right, looking out over the front. A bit more, and a bit more. And you'll see that right wing is actually responding, isn't it?
It is.
Okay, move it to the left, and you'll see that the left wing responds.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And that's all there is to flying, really.
It is
a little bit more complex than that, I do have to say. But if we were teaching you to fly, we'd be doing all of this in very steady steps. We haven't mentioned as well the rudder pedals, which confound all these modern pilots. If I take my feet off the rudder pedals now, and you then move the stick, then what happens in the aeroplane just turns into a big soggy, sort of half-empty plastic bag that wants to swish its way all over the place.
Okay.
I see you're doing all right so far.
Gentle
movements. So if you just squeeze pair is on the horizon, we'll just go in a straight line, because what you've turned us through about 180 degrees, so a bit of left, a bit more, just doing it with my knees like that, that's it, okay, and a bit of left pedal on the aircraft, we'll then go in a straight line. Okay, Rose, well done.
Thank you, I can relax now.
You can relax, I have control. Okay, would you like to throw it around a little bit? Okay, so what I'm doing now, this is a 30 degree angle of bank turn.
Wow.
Okay, and this is what I'll do in an airliner, because nobody in the back will know that I'm going round a corner. They won't drop their gin and tonics or papers and start screaming or anything. And the reason we do it in airliners is because we're not experiencing very much G-force at all.
No.
Okay, so if I wanted to rack the turn up a little bit, that's when you start to notice that we're actually going round a corner.
Okay.
And if you look down at the right wing, you see, that's one of the lovely things about the Tiger Moth, is that it just goes round on rails.
Like this. It's practicing on itself.
Yeah. So before we do any aerobatics, I'm just going to do a few checks. Okay. So I'm going to make sure that the height is sufficient. We're nearly at 4,000 feet, that's good.
Yeah.
The airframe, the slats are locked. Security, I'm tight and locked. Are you tight and locked?
I feel tight and locked, yes.
Good, good. My harness is done up then. And there's no loose articles, nothing else to worry about. T's and P's. Well, the pressure of the engine is good. And so I'm just doing a quick lookout turn just to make sure that there's no one around. And I'll start you off, Rose, with a gentle wing over, okay?
Okay.
So I'm going to lower the nose, I'm going to let the aircraft accelerate, all right? And then I'm going to raise the nose very gently, and we're just going to turn around and sort of describe a big arc like this.
Oh my God.
Okay, was that fun?
Yeah.
That, then we'll start, shall we?
Yes.
Okay. So I'll start you off with a loop.
Okay.
So down we go. Let your speed build up. Front your back to save the engine. Got enough speed. Up we go. yourself?
Amazing, yes, I certainly have.
Okay, well, we're just far to the west of Downton at the moment, so we'll just gently meander our way back down again.
Yep.
Let the speed build up a little bit. So, we finished aero, so the slats are unlocked. Trimmer set. And we're going back down. We're just sort of the Avon Valley and the fish farms, etc., are all down here on the right hand side. You can see Trafalgar House sitting, a nice country house sitting on the top of the hill in the 1 o'clock position, just to the right of the nose. I'll just pop it on the nose for you. And as we go down, you start to feel it gets a bit warmer.
Yeah, my legs. I can feel my legs now. That's good.
Yay. That's the why I put so many clothes on, basically.
Absolutely amazing.
So here we are overhead City.
Yep.
Get a nice view of the cathedral around here. Sadly, because of the way the wind's blowing, the runway we're using, I can't give you a picture of the cathedral on the GoPro. In fact, I will. I don't think there's anybody else around. Let's just have a quick look, have a whistle around. Golf of Ever Golf, joining extended base by the cathedral.
Right, copy the other inbound traffic now on the runway.
So, oh, there's a bird just gone past on the left-hand side, seagull. So there is the cathedral. So I'm just going to roll the wing to the right now, and we'll see if we can get it on the GoPro. The trouble with this machine is it rolls so quickly. And then ahead of us is Old Sarum Castle. So we've done the landing checklist. All we have to do is put this baby on the ground, as they say.
That's my job.
Sorry, say again?
I'm glad that's your job.
Well, you can say that when we've crawled away from the wreckage. So you see Old Sarum Castle, just it's under the nose at the moment, and we'll go past it as we go on to the final approach leg. And that's the site of the original site of Salisbury, and they moved down the hill to where the cathedral is. Because it was all just too small and cramped and unsanitary up there. But you can see the city walls, the big ones, they're sort of Roman, and all the Roman roads around here are very clever. They point exactly at the entrance to Old Sarum Castle, not just the castle, but the actual entrance. And we're just about to fly over a Roman road. There's one goes to the left of us and one to the right.
I always call Roman roads straight.
Golf November Golf, final for that.
Golf November Golf, Roger.
That's for a running change, John. We're alive.
No, that was such an amazing experience.
Right, so we've managed to turn around, that's good news. So I can release my goggles.
Can I release myself?
You can't release yourself, stay strapped in, please.
Okay,
and I know you probably want to get out as soon as you can. Well, don't thank me. I'm just a facilitator for GoFly. You've actually, well, you bid for this in a competition, didn't you?
I did, in an auction.
Well, I hope you paid less than the going rate for it.
No, I didn't.
Oh, okay. Well, well done.
Tell us what it was like then, now we can hear ourselves think.
Oh, it was absolutely amazing. I thoroughly enjoyed every bit of it, including taking the controls, having a wonderful time, turning, so did my stomach, eventually, it caught up with me. Sorry if that's so much.
What was the scariest bit?
The turbulence at the beginning, definitely. Because you're going quite slowly to start and quite low ground and...
Yes, so you're all recovered now, though.
I have.
Would you recommend it to others?
Oh, you've got to do it. Everybody has to do that. It is an amazing time. And put some Vaseline on your lips because you cannot talk. But thank you, Wei, for giving me the opportunity for doing that.
Well, thank you for your very, very good donation as well. Thank you.
You're more than welcome, thanks.
And of course, our thanks to pilot Mark and the team at GoFly Old Sarum Airport, just outside Salisbury. And if you'd like to find out how you can help raise money for Wave 105's Cash for Kids in all kinds of exciting ways, there's full information on the website at wave105.com/cashforkids.